How to install APK on Chromebook with developer mode. When you went to go ahead and install an APK, you got an error message, something like this or something of this sort. In this video, I'm going to show you how to bypass this and how to be able to install that APK on your Chromebook right away. How to enable the Linux development environment on Chromebook. Now, the first thing you want to do is go ahead and hit your search bar and then go ahead and type in settings or go to the settings app. Now, once you're here, you want to go ahead to the left-hand side, and at the bottom, you're going to see the About Chrome OS tab. Just go ahead and click on that. Now, next, you want to look for Developers, which is a subheading. Right under that, you're going to see the Linux Development Environment. Once here, just go ahead and click on Setup and wait for the pop-up. Once here again, go ahead and click on Next, and then you're going to be prompted to give a name. Now, I'm going to choose a simple name. You can also leave the name as it is, and once you're done, you're supposed to choose a disk size. Now, basically, you can go ahead and click on Custom and make this less than 10 gig if you don't have enough space, or you can make it more than 10 gig if you need more space. However, I'm going to leave mine on recommended. Later in the future, you can increase your space, and so I'll leave mine on recommended, and I'm going to go ahead and click on install right away. Now, this is going to install in the background, so let's move on to the next thing. How to enable ADB debugging on Chromebook. Now, the first thing you want to do is go ahead and hit the search bar and type in settings or go to the settings app. Now, once in settings, you want to go to the left-hand side and click on apps. Now, once you've clicked on apps, you're going to see manage Google Play preferences. Now, basically, we do not need the Google Play Store, but we need to make sure that we've already set this up or we've already installed this on our Chromebook. And if you already have this top down or this drop down right here, that means you've already installed it and you're set to go. Now, once that is out of the way, go down and click on About Chrome OS, which is the last on the tab. Once you've clicked there, go ahead and look for developers, because right under developers, we have the Linux development environment. Go ahead and click on that, and then you're going to find develop Android apps right here. Go ahead and click on that once again, and then you're going to see enable ADB debugging. Now, basically, there is a red flag with this. If you click on this, it's going to restart your Chromebook. And so make sure that you've saved everything that you're already doing to make sure that you do not lose anything after the restart. I'm going to restart this, and I'm going to see you guys on the other side of my screen. Now, once you've restarted your Chromebook, just go ahead and click on confirm, and that should bring you back to the normal page. Now, once we're done restarting, we're going to go back to our search volume, and then we're going to go ahead and type in terminal and then hit enter right away. Now, basically, once you're here, make sure to click on Penguin, which is right under Linux, and then it's going to load you into the terminal. Now, the first thing we need to do in the terminal is to check the version of the terminal. And so go ahead and type this with me, cat space with the forward slash etc, another forward slash, and type in Debian underscore version. And anything between 10 and 13 is pretty fine or pretty good for you. The next thing we need to do is update our terminal. So go ahead and type in sudo space apt space update and hit enter once again. Great. Now, once that is done, go ahead and type in sudo space apt space upgrade to upgrade all the updated packages. Now, once you're done with this, go down in description and click on the link down to my site to get the website that we'll be using to get the extra code that we need. Now, as you can see here, it says sudo apt install adb. Just copy this and then right click this into the terminal, which will paste it, and then go ahead and hit enter right away. Now, it's going to give you a prompt y/n. Go ahead and hit y and then hit enter to continue. That means yes in programming language. Great. Now, once that is done, we now have to go and find our apk. Now, for your apk, you can go ahead and get your apk from apk pure, apk mirror, or probably Aptoid as well. But the safest one that I've used in the past is APK Pure. Make sure it's not an XAPK, but it's just an APK, because some of the files can be XAPKs and that is not going to work for you. Now, basically, if you have your APK in downloads, that's perfectly fine. But I like to take my APK. Basically, this is a Notepad APK, and I'm going to drag this and put this in my Linux files. Or you can just go ahead and copy and then put this in the Linux files. Now, once this is here, go ahead and click on this, and then you want to right click this, and then you want to go ahead and rename this something very basic. And so, for example, I can just name my note instead of the notepad and all the extra characters there, because we're going to use this in the terminal. Now, once you're done with that, you want to go back to the terminal and type in ADB devices. Make sure that there's a space between ADB and devices, and then hit enter right away. Now, as you can see, it's asking me to allow USB debugging, and I'm going to click on allow right here because that's the important thing. Now, once you've enabled that, just go ahead and type in ADB space install space, then bring the name that you just pulled. Mine was note, as you can see back here. Mine was note.apk, so I want to go ahead and type in note.apk and hit enter right away. Now, as you can see, it says performing install, streamed install success. Now, if I hit the search bar and I type in notepad, you're going to see that the Notepad app that I just installed here, which says Notepad free, is right here. And so this is basically how you can go ahead and install any APK on your Chromebook. Just make sure that the APK is .apk and it's not X-A-P-K, because that's a whole different thing. But if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to smash the like, subscribe, and bell button, and come join my Discord down in the description if you happen to face a problem. With that said, it's your boy GD7 Plays, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out.